gear up for severe hardships during the coming monsoons, since the smart city works are much behind deadlines, the new 10th June deadline. The Rabandar area works have been completed. But the road works at Kakulo Mall, the footpaths up to sewage treatment plant, Tonka, and the footpath and drain works by the Centenis to Crematorium Road may only be completed by May 2025. CCP Mayor Rohit Monserrate has said that no legal action can be taken until the locals file a formal complaint to the authorities. He was responding to the alleged pay parking fees scam faced by Panjim locals. Mayor said that they have not received any complaint letter pertaining to pay parking. However, notice has been issued to the pay parking contractor to repair the signboards. On Thursday, Herald TV had highlighted how the pay parking staffer abused a Panjim motorist over parking fees. Concrete slab of a 50-year-old building located in Fera Baksha, near the Municipal Market Road in Mapusa, collapsed accidentally on Friday afternoon. The Kasrakar Kochkar building, opposite Kanekar Wine Shop, near Berry Petrol Pump, which was in a dangerous condition and on the verge of falling, caused significant damage when its slab gave way. Three bikes and two four-wheelers were damaged in the incident. The rates on the pay parking boards have been torn, hence motorists are victims of arbitrary pay parking charges. In this edition of Street Voices, Herald TV spoke to people to know their opinion on whether the CCP is responsible for the pay parking mess in Smart City, Panjim. The monsoons are likely to lash Goa with full force. Flooding is waiting to happen near Varsha Bookstall, near Azad Maidan Panjim, since the smart city workers have dug the footpath to construct the sewage chamber, thus bringing it to gutter level. Work on three grade separators for Nuvem, Gogal and Ravanfond Junction is scheduled to commence shortly. These three junctions have been facing traffic congestion as several major roads converge into these junctions. The consultancy for the work of this infrastructure has started work, and the work worth 7.5 crore rupees is bound to begin soon. Concerns have been raised by residents of Pona over the perilous road conditions prevailing at Amigos Junction in Kurti. Locals have voiced their apprehensions regarding the accumulation of water at the underpass junction, which leads to chaos and difficulty in navigating the roads, particularly during heavy rainfall. Residents have called for urgent action from the authorities to address the dangerous road conditions and ensure the safety of commuters at the junction. The Water Resource Department has drained the water from the quarry on the Kansalamkulam Road after two students tragically drowned in it last year. The connecting drain pipe below the culvert has been cleaned to allow flow of water to avoid flooding. WRD and local MLA conducted a joint inspection on Friday. A mobile repair kiosk situated near the old pickup stand in Margao fell victim to robbery. The incident, which occurred earlier on Saturday, resulted in a substantial loss estimated at around 60,000 rupees. Upon his arrival in Delhi, the recently elected Member of Parliament from South Goa constituency, Captain Virieto Fernandez, led a delegation including the Leader of Opposition of the Goa Assembly, Yuri Alemao, GPCC President Amit Patkar, and MLA of Kuepem Alton de Costa, to pay homage at Rajghat, the memorial dedicated to Mahatma Gandhi. Under Project Trust, Goa Traffic Police, in collaboration with the Director of Transport, inaugurated a Traffic Rules Understanding and Safety Training Center for food grocery delivery riders. IGP Omveer Singh Bishnoi emphasized the vulnerability of two-wheelers to road accidents and urged food grocery delivery riders to prioritize their safety while on the roads. Ramoji Rao, the head of Telugu News and Entertainment Network ETV and founder of Ramoji Film City, passed away at 87 in Hyderabad on Saturday morning. Rao was undergoing treatment for the past few days and breathed his last at 4:50 a.m., according to ETV Telangana, one of the Ramoji Group channels. The Padma Vibhushan awardee is recognized for being the founder of the Ramoji Group, which owns the famous integrated production facility Ramoji Film City in Telangana's capital city. In a thrilling display of skill and strategy, UC Serolim emerged victorious over UC Benolim in a captivating exhibition match held yesterday. The game, which unfolded amidst a moderate crowd, showcased Benolim's blend of fresh talent and seasoned players, launching a barrage of attacks against their opponents. However, it was Serolim's methodical approach and solid organization that ultimately dictated the flow of the match. Madel Sports Club Kuturi defeated Madel Sports Club 2-0 to enter the quarter-finals of 9A-side football tournament organized by Sporting Club Virbhat on Thursday. The tournament is being held at St. Alex Church Ground, Kuturi. The match started with a combination of rain and wind, and making atmosphere cool and playing conditions were good for players. Spectators were seen using umbrellas and raincoats around the ground. The devout congregation of Our Lady of Snows Church in Raya congregated in fervent prayer and celebration on Friday to mark the Feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Led by Father Alistair Gomes, an esteemed assistant parish priest hailing from Daman, Raya, the faithful came together in solemn observance.